Go to the Layers panel in Affinity Photo and select a layer. Then go to the Tools panel and select any of the shapes, rectangle, diamond, star tool. I'm going to go with a star tool and apply it. It can be applied with any color, doesn't matter. What you can also do, you can modify the number of points, maybe change the outer circle, etc. So you can modify it later as well. Go over here to the Layers panel, View Menu, Studio and Layers is the key thing, and then simply select that and then drag down just into the background there. You can see a little blue line appears between the image and the text. You do that, just hit release. Now, once you've done that, if you don't do that and you just it goes below, you can still move it back again and just make certain you get that line between the two. So you've got that star, you can select the star, and you can still, as long as the star over here is selected, you can modify the number of points, maybe change that so you can see more or less of the original design. You can also change all these other settings as well. You can also move it around. So you can just go over here to the Move tool and just move and reposition your design. What you can also do is you can go up here to the actual background. So here's the image, and you can also move that around. You notice there's a little lock there. If you want to move it around, simply click there. So just deselect that, and then you can use the Move tool and move that around instead. What you can also do is you can add effects. So I'm just going to quickly add an outer shadow, and that's via the FX just there, and then close. Now you can always go at any point back to the mask, and you can right click, maybe duplicate that design. So you get two masks. Now at the moment, obviously it's on top of each other, so it doesn't make any difference. But what you can do, you can select one or the other and you can just move them. And as you do that, you'll see what happens. You get a mask that's masking the mask. So it's a nice sort of design there. So you just get a bit less. You might not want that. You may want more. You can resize it, move it around, all kinds of things. And also what you can do, again, go to the star tool and you can still modify it. They're independent, so they don't have to be the same. You could change the number there. You can see you've got more of the points there. What you can also do is you can go and select another shape. You don't have to have just stars, maybe a rectangle. So apply a rectangle. Again, doesn't matter on the color, but you just apply it like that. Now, when you first apply it, it's above the design. It's not applied within there. So you can simply just drag that down. And again, what you can do, just put it there and you see that blue line appear again. And now the rectangle is there. Now you can move it around. You can position it down below and so on. So you can move it around all over the place. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to leave it there. And you can resize that, move that around. Also, rotate it as well to get, again, more or less of that original image. Also, what you can do, you can convert it to curves. So if you decide, you know what, I want it to be nodes. So instead, it's no longer something that can be changed very easily in terms of sort of the controls. But what you can do, you can go to the Node tool. There's the Node tool, and you can move these nodes, just reposition it so you can sort of position it that way. And it's a great way of maybe adding some curves into that design so you can just rotate that, move that, change that, and so on and so on. Also, if you want to design now, at any point, you can always deselect these, deselect them, and just get the original one. You can still see the designs there, you can still see the past there, but because it's selected, but if you just go back there, you can see now you haven't got it. But what you can also do, say you go over here, set the rectangle tool. I'm just going to add a rectangle, could be any size again, and I can add another rectangle. What I can do, I can select both of those, go to a layer, and I can say geometry and subtract. Now, you could try and do it within as a mask. Doesn't seem to work very well. So I must admit, whenever I do any sort of subtraction of a path, I always prefer to do it outside and then drag it into them as the mask. So again, simply select it, drag, and again, go there, and you can see that blue line appear, and release. And now you can see you've got your mask design there. Nice little frame, which you can resize and move. And you can always go to that background layer, and again, go there to the Move tool, and move that around as well. You can also lock the children, so lock children, and then move the image around. The mask doesn't move. Now I'm just going to select that background again and deselect that lock children, and you can continue to move that. What you can also do, hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate that design. And so you can see, you can create all kinds of unusual combinations of design with those masks, and they're all available, and you can again bring them in if you want or not. Hope you found this of interest. If you've got any questions, please let me know in the comments. Always great to hear anything that needs to be cleared up, or any other things you'd like to see in my videos, please let me know below. Always great. Thank you much.